gosh, I could really use a TikTok right now.
Made in 21, can you do something for me?
Are you wasting time scrolling to TikTok when you could be DIYing your new kitchen?
Well, come on down to the people because we have a new system where you can touch and see what your new kitchen will look like. Especially for you DIYers who love to do it yourself. So come on down to the people and get your new kitchen today.
How doers get more done.
God, Carl, can we please go to Home Depot today?
Why?
Because they have a new interactive showroom you can touch, feel, and see their kitchen. And right now, our kitchen looks like this. I think we could really use the upgrade.
It's not like I can say no.
Hi, welcome to Home Depot. My name is Abby. How may I assist you today?
I actually saw you on TikTok about your interactive showroom. We want to go check it out.
Yes, of course. Right this way.
Guys, we're presenting.
Oh, yeah. Hello, everyone. My name is Abbi Omorogbe.
My name is Gabby Thomas.
I'm Jessica Brooks.
I'm Nalanie Tran.
I'm Faban Moore.
And I'm Coby Hornsby. Wait, so what's the Home Depot and why is there a couple going there?
Great question, Coby. The Home Depot is the number one home improvement retailer in the world. This couple was here because the Home Depot is where doers get more done.
Their mission is to provide the highest level of service, the most broadest selection of products, and the most competitive prices.
Their vision is to respect all people, have excellent customer service, and give back to their communities and society.
The case challenge question is, with the growth and expansion of distribution centers, how might the Home Depot utilize additional space in their stores to create a showroom-type experience?
To solve this case challenge question, we incorporated our core competency, creativity, and innovation, where we made use of our opportunities to come up with a solution for the problem given to us by the Home Depot.
Yes, like Milani said, our core competency is creativity and innovation, and here's how we use the design thinking process throughout our presentation.
The first step is to empathize. Who even are the DIYers?
The next step was to define. What do DIYers need?
The third step is to ideate. What ideas could the Home Depot actually use?
Fourth step is prototype. What solutions would be beneficial to the Home Depot?
The fifth step is test. How would the Home Depot test their prototype?
So in our case challenge question, Faban read to us that it was a showroom type experience. Jess, do you know what a showroom is?
A showroom is a room that's used to display goods like appliances and furniture. Consumers can touch and feel products as well as interact and test them.
Who's the showroom for?
The Home Depot caters to two types of target markets, DIYers and pros. DIYers are like the couple wanting to renovate their new home.
Home Depot's second target market are pros. Think of them as individual professionals who remodel and renovate for a living.
As a team, we decided to choose DIYers. 75% are new homeowners, and they care about appearance and quality and believe quality outweighs price.
As we cater to DIYers, like Coby said, we believe a beneficial option for the Home Depot is an interactive showroom.
Customers are free to move around appliances that are placed on wheels for mobility with employee assistance. As you can see here, we created a physical model. It is engaging and interactive for the couple and easy for DIYers to visualize, and customers are able to see, touch, and feel the product.
So Coby, how many rooms will there even be?
There will be 5 total showrooms. The showrooms will consist of some sponsored by predominant brands such as LG, Whirlpool, Samsung, GE, etc. Other showrooms will be affordable off-brand options for low-budget DIY customers.
Customers have the ability to book an appointment prior to their arrival. This controls the flow of traffic and creates a secluded area for families to design their personal kitchen. Walk-ins are also available for customers if there's not an appointment already there. First come, first serve.
Looking at the layout, ideally the showroom will be located in this general area so that people walking along this main path can easily see it. It's close to the kitchen, which makes it a lot more convenient for the customers, and it's far from the entrance to prevent foot traffic.
Wait, so how would it look in my kitchen, and how much would it cost?
That brings us to our second option, which is a digital kiosk.
A kiosk would be a digital screen provided by the Home Depot where customers could enter the dimensions of their kitchen into them, and customers could create an account and sign up as a guest so they could keep track of their progress, and this would be located by the showrooms.
Customers have the ability to drag in their desired appliance onto their screen.
And for husbands like me who are on a budget, there's a refresh button on the top where you can see the new price every time you add or take away something.
To take an overview of our recommendations, we believe Home Depot could best utilize their additional space with an interactive showroom where they can touch and feel and see, and a kiosk where they could bring their ideas to life.
We recommend that the Home Depot uses both of these ideas to cater to those who prefer to touch and feel in person and to those who prefer to customize digitally.
How would the Home Depot market their prototype?
The Home Depot would advertise to social media. 47% of the target market DIYers have started or created a new project through an advertisement seen on social media.
Like we previously mentioned, here is a summary on how we use the design thinking process throughout our presentation.
During the empathize set, we researched about two of Home Depot's customers and ultimately chose the DIYers to focus our ideas on.
The next step in define, we figured out that DIYers care about appearance of quality and believe quality outweighs price.
The third step was to ideate. So we believe that the ideas that Home Depot could actually use was a touch, feel, and see kitchen and something that's realistic for each customer.
Fifth step was prototype. We created a physical interactive model and came with the idea of digital kiosks to execute our ideas.
The fifth step was test, which is surveys on social media.
So, don't you like our new kitchen?
Yeah, I'm so glad that you saw that TikTok and made me go to the Home Depot.
Thank you. Any questions?